All right, Hosses, welcome back. And in this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be making another view, aka we are going to be adding another web page to our website. So let's just have a little quick refresher on what a view is. A view is just a simple function that returns some HTML. That's all it is. So we need these because each URL pattern or each URL is connected to a view. So if we want to simplify that even more, each URL is connected to an HTML response. Obviously, each web page is connected to some HTML that needs to be displayed whenever you go to that. So what I thought would be pretty cool is if on the music homepage, whenever the user first goes to this section, then they can get kind of basically just look at all of their albums. So the album cover is going to pop up, and then they can scroll through, and when they click one of these albums, then it's going to take them to a more detailed view where they can see the artist and, you know, all the songs and the album name, so on and so forth. So again, we're going to have two pages. The first one is just the overview where you're going to see all of your albums, and the second one is the detail view. So let's go ahead and make that detail view structure right now. So let's just go ahead and do this. This might be a little bit easier. Above each of these patterns, I'm gonna add a comment and just write the exact pattern that it's matching. So this one, we didn't match any pattern. So that means that they just went to the homepage with no extra information after it. Now the pattern that we're gonna be matching in this is this. Music, and I think the best URL structure is after music, you just type in the album ID. So remember, one was Taylor Swift, two was Myth, but let's just go ahead and put like 71 in here, just so we have a little example that is what the structure is. So basically music followed by some ID. So what we always have to do whenever we're making these patterns or trying to figure out what the user typed in is always type URL and then a regular expression. So R, two single quotes. Put my comment at the end there. So whenever you use regular expressions, 90% of the time in these cases, you use caret, dollar sign. So the caret represents the beginning and the dollar sign represents the end. So that's just how you signify beginning and end using regular expressions. Now, what we also wanna do is we wanna group these together. So a group takes a bunch of things and signifies that this is one item. So that way, whenever we type something like 712, it doesn't view this as 7, 1, and 2. It's not three different numbers, it's actually one number, 712. So of course the user was looking for album with the ID 712 and not, you know, three different albums. So later on, whenever we figure out what number the user typed in, what album ID they were looking for, we're gonna have to pretty much save this as a variable so we can use it in our code. So how do we do that? Well, this is actually kind of weird, but you write question mark, capital P, and then greater than and less. So go ahead and write something like album ID right here. So later on, whenever we look for this pattern and extract the integer, it's gonna save it as album ID. So then we can just pass it in our function just like normal. So again, I know it's weird, but hey, you gotta blame Django and you know, whoever came up with the regular expression. So there you go. All right, now after this, we can finally start matching this pattern. So what are we looking for in the ID number? Well, we're looking for a digit, 0 to 1, first of all. So how do we do that? Add two square brackets and write 0 to 9. So this means that we're looking for a number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now this is gonna be great if we only have 10 albums possible, but the thing is, we are looking for, you know, 11 and 12 and 100 and 1,000. So we need to say, okay, this is gonna match any integer, but we want these IDs to be, you know, several decimal places long. So after this, we write plus. And this means that this pattern is gonna match any following integers. So 712 is gonna hit, or pretty much anything that's a combination of single integers we're going to group them together into one single ID, which is going to represent a number. Sounds kind of weird, but again, you have to write to the people making regular expressions and blame them for us. And by the way, once we do like two or three more, you guys are going to be like, okay, you're just going to like type them this fast and not even really think about it. This is probably only confusing the first time, but there you go. So the next thing we have to do after we find this pattern is we need to connect it with a view function. So actually, let's just go ahead and make our view function right now. And I'm just going to name it detail. So every single view function is going to take the request, and the request is just the HTML request. And this is just whenever they connect to your site and request something like a web page or an image or whatever. And there's a lot of background information about this, like their IP address and yada yada. We really don't look at too much, but that's what that is. Now, the next thing we really care about is this album ID. And again, like I said, what this bit of code does is it allows us to treat the album ID just like a variable. So we can just pass it in, and this is just going to be equal to something like 1 or 2 or 712 or 10,000, whatever. Pretty awesome, eh? All right. So we have a function, and now we just need to return some HTML. So return HTTP response, and let me just make this a heading too. And for this tutorial, we aren't actually going to connect to the database and pull out, you know, like the album title or the artist or anything like that. Gotta, you know, kind of try to keep things simple here. So I'll just say details for album, I'll say album ID. And then let me go ahead and write string album ID, and I want to move this to the end as well. Alright, looking good. So that looks pretty good. Whenever we call this function, it's just going to turn details for album ID 1, 2, 3, whatever. Make sure I follow PEP 8 and have a blank line at the end. And alright, so remember that function that we just created is called detail. So whenever we want to hook up a URL pattern to it, we just need to say views, because that's the name of the module, detail. Pretty cool, eh? And you don't add the parentheses at the end because it knows all the variables from these groups already. So the last thing I want to say is just this. Add a name and just name it whatever the function is. And I'm not going to touch on this because this is kind of what we're going to use later, but whenever you have a name, it allows you to do some really cool things in your HTML later on. So there you go. Now, actually, there's one other thing before I forget. So what this does is it looks at this and it's going to pull out the number. However, what we need to do is we need to say, okay, this pattern also has a little forward slash after it. So look for the pattern with the number and the forward slash, pull out the number, and treat it as album ID, and we're just gonna ignore the forward slash. That isn't part of the group. All right, cool enough. Now let me just refresh this. All right, that still works. Now let's go ahead and check out this. Whenever they go to album ID 2, it says details for album ID 2, and this is gonna be myth. Whenever they go to 1, there we go. It's gonna display Taylor Swift. And right now we can even go to 3 or any number such as bada bada whatever, and that is because we are not actually connecting to the database yet and validating that it is a valid album ID and we actually have something stored for it. So that's your basics of views. Again, it's actually really simple. Just look for whatever URL the user typed in and connect it to one of these functions right in there. All the tutorials online and all the documentation makes it seem really hard, but it's not. So yeah, that's it. I'll see you guys next time.